Smile. No. Smile. You look just body when you do that.
Jesus.
Alright, okay. Here we go. Hello and welcome to another episode of Bloody Board Games, where we at Ghastly Tales play horror-themed board games for your viewing pleasure. I'm joined by...
Martin Yates.
Callum.
Callum McPhail.
And Martin, who are going to be on an intrepid adventure with us to solve many mysteries, for we are playing the Sherlock Holmes game. Is that what it's called? Master Detective game.
Sorry. Oh, shit. But when you say, like, the Master Detective game, it makes it sound like some generic thing. Like, it's not actually a Sherlock Holmes game.
It's the Sherlock Holmes game, and it says Master Detective underneath it.
Cool. So we're a bit of an egotist.
We dodged the bullet.
Quite tenuously horror-related as well.
Yeah, but there's murder and
there's been a murder.
Stuff.
There's been a murder.
That famous also, horror show, Tiger.
Yeah.
Also, I'm too poor to keep on buying games, so I have this game, so we're going to play this one out.
But if $10,000 a month is donated to our patron, we'll get 2 to 3 games every year.
I know.
Sounds good.
So, anyway, we don't have a Patreon, just in case you're
looking. Yeah, no, just in case you're looking for it.
We have a hat that we leave outside Callum's flat. Yeah. People can just walk past.
But that's my money.
We'll give us an address in the comments.
Alright, so the first thing you need to do in this game is you need to choose a case. There are 75 cases.
We're going to read through them all.
And each case has prerequisites for being solved. They normally have 3 things that you need to guess before you can actually win the game. Each time you're one of your little Sherlock Holmes men here goes into one of the locations, you look to the back of the card and you see that location, you see there's a corresponding case number on it, or clue number, and you go to the back of this book, you read what the clue is, you don't let anyone else hear it, and you then note it in your head, or you note it down on your wee...
Kind of like when you had an annual as a kid, and it was like, which Cliff Richard track in 1987 was... And then you would go, oh, it's such and such, and you'd look at the back, it'd be upside down, you would turn it round, then it would give you the answer.
Exactly.
But you would know it because you knew
everything. What I'm really worried about...
I didn't understand the build-up, but I understood the point. So right. Well done.
What I'm really worried about is the fact that Cliff Richard has been mentioned twice in the last...
First mentioned him before we started.
I know that, but still.
You treat him.
Sorry.
Tony Blackburn.
So
you treat was onto him for a bit, wasn't it?
You treat onto everyone.
So
it does.
So, gentlemen, we start off at 22 Baker Street. Choose your homes.
Well, I've actually been carving this one while you've been talking.
So you have the...
I've got this nice brown one.
Jobby Holmes.
That's actually carved out of a...
Jobby?
A Yorkie.
Rosewood.
Oh, Yorkie, yeah. So you better play quick.
Mine has... mine's been to the spray tan parlour.
You've been to a certain part of Glasgow and acquired that one.
Yes.
And
the orange home.
Mine is covered in blood because, much like Dexter, he is both... Dexter's not a detective. I was going to say he's a detective and
he's a blood spatter analyst.
Yeah, he's covered in blood. Okay, so we need to choose a case to play. Now, I have some here. We do have one here which we think is probably the winner.
Skip to 47 minutes, guys, and we'll have finished.
Yeah, we're going to go through all them. Some of the titles are like The Adventure of the Suicidal Architect, The Adventure of the Locked Chamber, The Adventure of the Eternal Sleep, Sherlock Holmes, and The Dead Tramp. Which was...
That sounds pretty
that's
good.
That's a hot contender.
I think, so we'll put that one aside. Mm. We also have The Case of the Murder in the Maze, which made me think of The Shining, so I just thought that might be interesting. Okay, no. The Case of the Body in Question,
it's always going to be a body in question if it's an investigation, isn't it?
The Mystery of the Mummy's Curse, which I thought was
suited to Jack. Horror Hammer related, yeah.
Put that in maybe. The Adventure of the Bloodthirsty Bard.
Oh, well, they're always
certainly good with alliteration. I'll give them that.
The Adventure of the Duplicate Deaths.
More alliteration.
No. The Mystery of the Impossible Death. The Case of the Strangled Lawyer.
Yes.
Probably had it coming to him.
Sherlock Holmes and the Rhyme of Death. He lays down some rhymes.
Is that when Sherlock Holmes met his end in a rap battle?
Yeah.
That's how Tupac went.
No. The Case of the Melancholy Dane.
Right.
Whether it's a dog or someone from Denmark.
Right. We're dangerously close to reading all these out there.
No, we're at the end of them. The case of the Flying Scotsman, which I thought was...
This is the fastest 75 I've ever counted.
No, no, these are just the ones that I thought were more relevant to Ghastly Tales.
Flying Scotsman.
Yeah. Oh, no, then. The Adventure of the Avenged Author.
Who cares about that? We don't want him to start looking for revenge. That just sets a bad precedent if he starts looking for revenge.
The Adventure of the Posthumous Client. That sounds rubbish. All right, so...
Sorry, Arthur.
All right, and the one that we think is probably a winner, which is... The Adventure of the Bludgeoning Bobby.
Bobby. Now, shall we explain?
In Scotland, the word Bobby means penis.
Yeah. Penor.
But Bobby is also an old name for a police officer.
Yes.
Which is obviously
who also from has a penis.
Robert
but
Peeler.
The fact that you have
because he peeled his penis.
But you have a bludgeoning Bobby.
Well, you bludgeon your Bobby.
Really?
When you bludgeon,
with our...
No one in Scotland would do such a thing, but it
there's another one where.
And maturity reigned with that one.
Or there's another one where Holmes and Watson beat a tramp to death in a car park, but that was a very quick solve, so. Even for us.
Who killed this tramp?
The case,
Bans, remember?
Right, okay, oh, yeah. So.
Okay, that was was meant.
I think. So, are we whittling it down to Sherlock Holmes and the Dead Tramp? The
no,
dead,
we're just going Bobby.
Are we just. Yeah. Right, it's Callum deciding.
What you go Bobby?
I don't know if there's something funny about Sherlock Holmes and the Dead Tramp.
Right, Dead Tramp it is then.
No, we'll go bludgeon Bobby. It means a lot to you. It means a lot to you. And you did win the last round of bodyboard game, so...
By a technicality, by unfortunately not knowing...
By cheating!
Yeah, well, by a perversion of the rules, so... Yeah, okay. Well, everyone's won once now, so let's
Michael
count my... Yeah, he did, he won Gloom.
So, we have to read the case out, gentlemen. Now, at any time, you can pick this card up and read it again.
Okay.
Okay. Well, here we go. The Adventure of the Bludgeoning Bobby. Three strangely similar murders, one each night, have occurred in London during the past 3 nights. In each case, the victim was a large, well-built man in his early 20s. Each victim had been bludgeoned to death by a bobby. Sorry, it doesn't actually say that.
Yeah, I was...
Hit over the head with a...
Truncheon.
Blunt object.
Oh,
each had apparently been killed in the early morning hours around dawn. Each body was found in or near the park.
Also known as the case of the morning wood.
Sam's trousers.
Each victim had fresh black earth under his fingernails.
I bet you did.
And perhaps the oddest similarity of all is the fact that each of the three victims was seen in the custody of a policeman the night of his death.
Oh, bet you.
The three victims were Barney Grandweather, a locksmith's apprentice, William Beck, a porter at the hotel... The hotel.
The London Hotel.
And this fits quite nicely, McLean Forrester, a docker. Down at the docks.
Is he an ice docker or just a regular docker?
Both Grantweather and Beck on separate nights were seen as they were stopped by a constable and apparently arrested outside the Boar's Head. Forrester was last seen talking with a policeman outside the theatre. In each instance, witnesses were able to identify the policeman only as a man of medium height, medium build, and of medium age.
So a fucking boring bastard.
40 years of age. The constables currently on night duty in the general area of the Boar's Head and the theatre are Barnaby Hawkins, Ross Carruthers, and Ainsley Deacon. But all of these men are well under 40 and none of them profess to have seen the victims before the murders.
Well, did it not say something about someone in their early 20s?
Yeah, that's
That's the Bobby.
Right.
Yeah, I'm confused now, Martin. You've confused me.
Right, let's...
Let me finish this, right? Stop fucking derailing me. Scotland Yard, extremely concerned about the possible involvement of a policeman in this shocking series of murders, is desperate to find the killer before a public panic sets in. Inspector Lestrade, pressured by his superiors for a swift solution to the murders, has come to 221 Baker Street.
221B.
221B Baker Street. To review the
facts... 221 Baker Street.
To review the facts with the Master Detective. Lestrade wants to discover A... You just want to write this down.
221A Baker Street.
Who killed the three men? B, the weapon used, and finally, the motive. The game is afoot.
Just letting people know.
Who done it? What done it? Why done it?
Alright, that's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Okay, so we all roll dice to see. Oh, first of all, we each need to take one of these.
Do we all need to think of what the last zombie film we watched was?
Yes.
No, that was.
That's still the last rom-com.
Okay, so
last Sherlock Holmes film.
Obviously, when you get a clue, if you think it's important, you might want to block the other players from finding out what that clue is, so you can put down one of the Scotland Yard cards, which seals off the area as a crime scene. And the only way you can get into it is if you have a key.
And you can get more of them from the relevant
place. You're not allowed to possess more than one of each of these. If you are out and you want more, if you go to the locksmith, you pick up a key. If you go to Scotland Yard, you'll pick up a Scotland Yard
badge.
Splendid. Okay, so let's roll and see
who
goes first.
Nice big board, I'd like to say to begin with, that we're good for rolling.
Starters, you mean to go on?
Five, that's not bad. Five.
Now what happens is you need to wrestle naked.
That's fine.
Unless he's got a one here. This is more exciting than the actual game. You get a one here, I'm leaving. McPhail's out.
Couldn't let it go on forever.
Alright, McPhail and Jobby.
Right, now, can I see the card? Is this the case of the bludgeoning Jobby? Well, I believe one of the first places that was listed, each body was found near a park, but it also had some information about the theatre, so I shall go quick smart to yon theatre. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I guess we'll just do it fucking clockwise.
3, 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
So what am I aiming for here?
You want to look at the case and you want to see the different locations that are involved.
Okay. Yeah.
I'll just be 45 minutes while I read this.
Right, okay. Calvin, you doing
alright? Yeah, not bad. Just
been happening recently.
Just
it's a nice watch you've got.
Well, thanks very much. I had a bit of a problem the other day. Someone bumped into
me. What do the numbers mean on the back?
Bastard.
What do the numbers mean on the back?
Don't read them!
When you look at the numbers, when you get to the actual location,
that's the page number where the information
number
is.
To go to
right, okay. Alright.
So it's not like page 12, 13, 14, 15, so that when you find one clue, you get them all.
I just scanned through until I saw a location, so I'm going to move towards that location.
Hey! The glass! Alright.
Can you sit
you
on
should,
the same...
What is my code?
Can you sit on the same tile as someone else?
Well, yeah, you can, but don't. I'm not fucking turning my back to
but
you.
Normally that means you get papped
like,
in the wall.
Oh, like... Oh, I'm kidding. Right, next.
Right.
Are you stalking?
3. If you roll 3 or higher, you survive. No. 1, 2, 3. So I'll end my turn next to the Tobagnonigist. It's by Michael Stoll.
Oh, 2. Shit in a poke.
Michael's going for a confident roll. 5. Oh. What is his long-term game plan? Who knows?
1, 2, 3. Here we go, boys.
2, 1.
In the park!
There he is.
Right, so I look here.
That guy's quite recklessly driving a carriage around.
Here.
Across the grass as
park.
Well.
Park. So
mania.
It's 337. Now, there's an element of trust in this game, which is that you're not looking at everything.
Looking at each other, so
So I need to make sure it's case number 10. And it's clue 337.
But it's also intentionally designed that each of the clues are split up.
Oh, quick. Yeah. Be careful you don't go to the back there because... right to the back because actually the solutions are there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Be careful you don't.
Next to Cliff Richard answers.
Oh, right. Yeah. The clues are just sequential. So, what was that again? 337. So, 337.
Staedtler probably do make the best pens. A lot of people think it's Bic, but I think Staedtler make the best pens. What do you think, Martin?
Paper mate, heart of communication.
Paper mate are good.
Yeah.
Bic's hard to go wrong. Sharpie's come really into their own kind of more recently. I really hope Michael hurries up.
Yeah. What's
Parker.
They are the Rolls Royce of the pen world. Yeah.
I think probably the best pens you get, the Montblanc pens.
Okay, right. Enough of this boring chat.
Enough of this useless banter.
What was it that guy called you on the live stream, mate?
The boring the one. Oh no, it was the dunker.
The dunker. Yeah.
There you go.
It's true.
A dish pan.
Oh, check
look
that.
At this. Six. One, two.
He's going
three,
to cast
four,
generators.
Five, six.
I kind of feel like you should get it wrong again if you have a six, but I don't think there's anything about that.
Now, does that count as me being in or am I outside it?
You're outside it.
Right, that's
you're looking in, you're like, oh, I'm so close.
What's going on in there? You can't come in, Mr. Holmes.
Right, I am.
You've still got your needle in your arm.
Locking this mofo down.
And he's making a fast escape.
And now you're going to guard the exit.
Yes.
Fucking hell.
Oh. How many?
Fuck off.
Perfect. Right. There you go, mate.
Laugh so much if you rolled a zero there.
Don't go right to the back. Just go.
Yeah.
And once you put the book down, you're not allowed to look again. So... be smart, Jim.
Oh, wait. Clue 248. Wait, fuck, that's not a page number, or is it?
No, it's not a page number, mate. It's like, see if you go, I'll not look at it, but see if you.
You have to go to the case.
See them.
Right, okay, right. What case number is this? 10.
No, you don't go to the case number, it's sequential, so just
go to
the numbers.
Okay. Oh, fuck's sake! No, this isn't the old part of the game, this is a nonsense. Fucking Sherlock Holmes wouldn't put up with this. That's why he always calls Watson an idiot.
I know!
Watson, you're brilliant! Stop moving it, you fool! Even though you're a fully trained medical professional.
Watson, Holmes, I've dropped the gun! I fumbled it in my fingers!
Here's my companion, silly Watson!
Blast you, Watson!
You silly prick. Alright, okay.
Sherlock Holmes' dying wish is to just strangle Watson to death.
I always wish
solve this.
I know. Right. That's the only reason he had him along on his adventures. So
hope he gets shot.
You guys can carry on, by the way. I'm like,
all right, well, I'm doing.
Yeah,
not bad.
Oh, that's my shot. Okay.
Oh, smash up.
Oh, Calum's just went smash up.
Right, there you go. What's your favourite colour of plastic?
And relevant to the game or just in general? Like, what really, really turns you on?
What
like
colour
plastic?
Of plastic do you like?
I quite like red plastic.
Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But then I like blue plastic as well.
Yeah.
If only we could mix the two of them together, but you just get brown.
Red and blue?
Is that not made brown?
Purple.
Is that what it is? Purple?
Well, red. Purple's basically like a reddish blue.
I know, and he's out colouring me. Yeah. Right. Okay.
Look like you're playing with some purple there.
One. I'm not doing very well. I've rolled.
McPhail.
He's too busy solving crimes, Martin.
I am indeed. Right.
He's not locking it down, so he doesn't care about what's in it.
It'd be more fun if they were all different detectives, like you had Poirot and Miss Marple.
The rights would be a nightmare.
Batman.
Yeah, it just swings across the board. But oh, you fucking knocked me back in the park.
Right.
Sake.
Oh, why am I? Oh, okay.
Oh, wait a minute. No. You're on here. You're here.
No,
so any move you make has to be taken from here.
No, I'm there.
No, you moved here.
No, I did. I lifted it. Listen, there's nothing in the rule book that says that. If there was something in the rule book that said that, I would quite happily defer to you, yes. But there's not. So stop trying to be a cheater.
You're lying.
Oh, rolling sixes all the time.
Better be something in the boar's head. I'm going to go. Fucking Raj.
Your turn.
Haha! I'm in the hotel. I might just stay the night.
That's what he's like when he's going on holiday. Yes! I'm in the airport!
Haha! I was once on a bus to Aberdeen and the driver. No, guys, calm down. What's going on?
Well, we're just doing our turns while you're coming out to you.
Oh, talk shit.
Aye, thanks.
I'll take your turn, Mike.
And I'll go.
No.
And I'll get on that boat. And I'll sail away from a town of murderers. Reading the rule books always so much fun. The game is in danger of getting too much fun. So read the rule book.
I'm not reading the rule book.
I know, but it feels like you're reading the rule book, doesn't it?
Well, just talk about yourselves. It's not my fault that you're so boring.
Do you like... What kind of filler could you like best?
I like the red stuff.
The red stuff is good.
The red stuff is good. Cherry flavor.
But you know what?
When I mean, flavoured.
See when I smell proper vanilla? Just the original?
What, just vanilla? Vanilla fairy liquid? Original green.
It just takes me back to being a kid.
Smells delicious.
When I used to get...
So what you're saying is you dress up as a baby.
I used to make hot water and the washing up liquid and you'd have bubbles and things like that.
Oh. See, this is the thing. Like, see, when you move out and you live on your own, you get a lot more less discerning about what washing up liquid you buy.
Another one.
Slow and or steady ones are... But, alright, wait, so shouldn't you be there? Were you not in the hotel?
Yeah, here you go.
Sure, I'm just trying to help you out.
Thanks, McPhail.
1, 2, 3. Ah, we meet again.
Not quite.
You fiend.
Are you just following each other?
No, he's following me, technically.
Oh, yeah, finally it's on.
I'm hot on the trails of this Protestant.
What?
You're orange.
Yeah. Yeah?
It has racial overtones.
Ah.
Religious connotations. 5!
Actually, to make this game more interesting, I think that's what we're going to have to do.
Ha ha! A roll of the die seals your fate.
The Bobby's head. Where's the. It's in the Bobby's head.
The Bob was dead.
the boar was dead.
Sorry again, Mick. It's not so much your story, but perhaps the dry, monotonous tone, Martin Yates. Which is something that's frequently commented on our videos, but me and Martin, and me and Michael actually go through them and delete them all in order to save Martin the drama.
Yeah.
Reading the book! It's really good to watch people reading the book without saying anything.
Should we just see whoever rolls the highest has solved the crime?
Whoever reads the sentence the fastest wins. I used to think it'd be great being a detective, but now I just realise it's reading a pamphlet. Thank you. And interestingly, Martin's not...
The victim was in his 20s, that's what it was.
Oh, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Come home, you drunkard! Your wife is looking for you. Oh, thanks, man! I'll just end the game with you!
It's fine.
Yeah, it's fine.
Right.
You have to get back there anyway to...
Ah, but Martin hasn't solved the case. The Bob's head. 371.
It's never going to get
penis!
Who's your favourite Sherlock Holmes?
Brett Spiner.
It's got to be Jeremy Brett, isn't it?
He's quite good.
I don't really watch Sherlock
The most likable... Sherlock Holmes is Peter Cushing,
yeah.
But then he's like your fucking granddad out solving mysteries.
I always find Sherlock Holmes a bit boring.
There's a good one from... Does Christopher Lee not play Sherlock Holmes?
Yeah, he did two films.
Aye.
They're on Netflix, like 1989 and 1990.
Jeremy Brett's a fucking maniac. He like forgot who he was. He like fucking thought he was Sherlock Holmes. And then they found him like putting fucking heroin in his cornflakes.
He was manic depressive, I think. Do you remember it?
That's not an excuse. But 371. You're not a period detective! I'm a manic depressive! You're not a period detective! You don't know psychology! 371. The what? This has used the word dank, which now has completely different connotations. That's a dank meme. Dank's now used, I believe, to mean the word cool.
I think it means, I'm not sure. How would you translate that into standard English? Like a dank
Say
meme.
That again?
Dank as in, like, a meme. Like a dank meme.
But like dank is like something like kind of like dark and like it's kind of dingy, isn't it?
Lost. Won't be the first time, won't be the last.
Victims, but a dank meme.
Yeah, there's a lot of writing and not talking in this game.
Yeah.
Which, as you've explained, McPhail, is brilliant for people watching this.
Victims goes.
Can I tell you a little story?
No.
I'm not talking to you, I'm talking to the camera. Can I tell you a little story?
No.
No!
Yep. Interjection!
Okay, so I have just entered into the carriage depot card, please. Now, the carriage depot allows you to go to any location on the board, but first and foremost, there is a carriage depot clue, which I must now read.
The only problem is you must talk to the carriage driver on the way around, and he is a racist.
Yeah. I hate that, so when you get a taxi driver that's a racist. You're just like,
do you know the worst thing is like when you're in a taxi like with someone else, someone riles the taxi driver up and then leaves you in the taxi.
Oh fuck yeah, oh, Jesus, yeah.
Yeah, alright, I did that to Alan once.
That wasn't what I meant.
Yes it was. The guy,
tell us the story, the guy, Uncle Michael.
Me and Alan shared a taxi and I was getting dropped off first and the driver ended up being quite very, very religious, hardcore Muslim, and basically thought that homosexuals were dubbed and that gay people couldn't fall in love. And I was like, wait a minute. And I spoke to him about it and I sort of debated with him about it. And then I had to leave the taxi because I got to my house.
And when he got out of the taxi, he patted Alan in the shoulder and went, I'll see you later, love.
I tagged Alan in. And
Alan deployed his Trump membership and then they carried on silently.
Yeah, because Muslims love Donald Trump.
That's true.
And vice versa.
He's deflecting the attention away. He's making them sympathetic characters.
Is he?
Listen, Donald Trump's secretly Muslim.
I think we're in a lot of trouble if Donald Trump becomes president in America.
Well, yeah, America certainly is.
Alright, so...
Ghastly Tales Hard Talk!
But he's going to make YouTube great again, so don't forget.
You're
dice.
Up.
Dice.
No, you don't get any dice anymore. We've changed the rules.
Six. Oh! See that? See that?
That was the McPhail roll. That was the McPhail magic. Three. Half a six. No. Half a victory.
Not quite as good.
One.
Still diagonally beat in contact.
I can move to any place on the board, and I choose to go...
Why is it over there? You said anywhere on the board, I just moved into anywhere on the board. So the head seemed like within the board.
Take one of these.
Most friendly looking spot. Mm-hmm.
And I will also look at the clue.
Confidential case files. Excuse me, I'm not a practicing police practitioner, but please let me have a look at it. Oh, it's alright, Sherlock Holmes, it's fine.
Can I have a look at your medical records?
Did you ever think it was a bit bullshit that, I mean, obviously he was quite an accomplished detective, but he seemed to, like, pretty much completely override the police in every case.
Yeah, it's a lot of shite.
Mm. See, in, like, 70s Britain, he wouldn't have got very far, would he? Because someone like that that was able to turn up legitimate facts about people didn't last very long. Savile would have got Savile, the IRA on them.
Yeah.
I watched a video the other day, it was top 10 most evil wrestlers, and you forget that Savile was a wrestler for a little while.
That's bros.
So he was in it.
That's a great pick.
You're not technically a wrestler if you only wrestle children though, right?
Fucking hell.
I know. I'm going for the championship belt. A tag team match.
It's a unification match.
Tag you in, Rolf.
Christ. Gary! Right, okay, there you go. Yates, you're up.
That's how you approach him. That's how you approach him to me and his team. He said, do you want to be in my gang?
According to Callum's rules, does he have to re-roll it?
No, a cock die is when another dice can't be placed on top of that. That's fine.
Where's another dice?
Well, we don't have another dice.
So we can never prove it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Dogs.
5, 6.
Oh! Into oh my god!
Splash! No. Troll 2 the fuck out of this.
I just feel that Yates is now just going through the motions. He doesn't even really care.
But
you know, I've got a lot of money riding on you, son.
I hope there's something really boring, but it's like he gets there and it just says, Yes, it is confirmed the man worked at the docks.
There are boats here.
Yeah. Everyone is drunk.
He's just. Do you ever miss Martin's ponytail?
No.
No.
It's me that cut it off.
What's it, Martin?
Well, he slept with a fucking blunt Swiss Army knife.
Do you think you'll ever go for the ponytail again?
It pissed me off.
Why? We didn't say about you.
Behind his back.
I know.
Oh, yeah. No. Well done.
Just constantly, anytime he said it, at the end.
Fool! Fool!
Idiot.
No, Martin. I know. Martin, only fool.
You idiot.
Martin always said, though, he'd cut his hair off if he got my film role that would, like, you know, want it.
I know.
For a long time, I was looking for something.
In one scene where it's just, like, a short-haired man walks in and then leaves immediately.
I know. A short-haired man is seen. A short-haired man's shadow is seen. That's right. Must have short hair for convincing shadow.
Brilliant, though. Idiot. Ponytail constantly. Idiot. You never get anything right.
Better come back here to the 80s.
Make failure up.
Cool. It just kept saying Point Break to him. By all accounts, you hear the new Point Break is shit.
Yeah.
Oh,
so.
Before I depart.
Can he just...
Nino, 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 Nino. But I threw it behind me like a smoke grenade. The scene is closed. To the herbal shop. No, Holmes, you're on a case. Quiet, Watson. Fear.
You're older to
spy.
Look at that! Did you see that? There was no passion, there was no involvement, there was no commitment to that role.
Dry.
No.
What's happened?
I don't know. Fine. Nothing.
He drank one Bulmers and that was it.
He's just remembering himself skipping through fields with his ponytail.
With the ponytail swinging behind him going, idiot!
Yeah.
Idiot!
But like, when he cut it off and it was dying, he held it in his hands, it was like, we had some good times, ponytail, didn't we?
Yes, Martin, we had some good times.
Idiot!
Fucking idiot! Idiot! Quivering in his hand.
And Martin put up with the smell of burning hair, which many people know is horrible. Right. Whose turn is it?
Yours.
Yours.
Right. One, two, three. Fuck. I'm actually growing the top of my hair out, so it could well become a centipede.
He's growing the top of his hair.
Hello, I'd like to make a deposit.
No!
That's funny, that's what the Bobby man
says. No, Mr. Whitehouse, it's not that kind of bank! Right, okay, so 150. Every time I think of a bank, I just think of Mary Poppins.
Did you see the...
Happens. Speaking... Prudently invested in the fiduciary.
That's all I know about really. Banks. I was expecting that the first time I opened up my account. I was solely disappointed.
On the wooden leg named Smith. On Mary Poppins,
I'm not really
is one of the best films ever made.
Best horror films ever made.
And if anyone disagrees with me, I will fight you.
Dick Van Dyke, flawless execution in terms of accents.
I'll tell you something about that, right? Mary Poppins! Step inside! Step inside! The thing is, right, people get onto him about his accent,
uh-huh.
But the truth is, when he does the accent of the older man at the end, his English accent's spot on. So he's obviously doing it for a laugh when he does.
Aye, because that bit was dubbed.
Cockney accents is different.
That bit
right?
was dubbed. Just,
yeah.
That's always a bit. Michael's only ever seen that film at home, and it's actually his dad saying, "That's the film finished now, Michael." God, that sounds awful like an old man. That's very convincing.
Right, yeah, shut up.
You've derailed me. I was going to say something
four,
brutally funny, unrelated to Mary Poppins.
Two, three, four.
Fucking four. One, two, three, four. That was silly. I probably should have gone in the docks, eh? But fuck it. Go.
Fiduciary. I feel like Martin's now.
Sorry. So we're talking about banks, four. Right? Banks. there's also sperm banks, you know, they've just...
I made that joke, I said...
It's not a joke.
It was a very funny joke.
It's not a joke.
It was a funny joke.
What I'm saying is they've just successfully made the first sperm from stem cells.
Yeah, so...
Pretty cool. I think they'd made it from bone marrow before, but it wasn't as tasty. What do you think about Village of the Damned starring Christopher Reed?
Oh, it's pretty bad.
Christopher Reed.
I said Christopher Reed.
He said Reed, definitely, 100%.
Oliver Reed, son.
Because he controls my brain. Christopher Reed. Puts it out. I pulled the Reed lever to make him seem like a buffoon.
It's a pretty terrible film.
That's not great.
Docs.
I really, like, it's not like it's I like Hamm's all of John Campbell's films. I really dislike vampires.
Do you think of Kirstie Alley's in it? Mark Hamill might well be in it.
Pre-fat Kirstie Alley.
Not that pre-fat, I don't think.
Fat contemporary is fat. Yeah.
What are your thoughts right now?
I don't really have any thoughts. This is the problem.
None of your own.
I'm kind of just a bit tired and.
See, last time we played, you were like, "Way!"
Yeah, this time you're I can't keep up. I can't keep up with the energy that's going on in the room right now. I'm feeling fall night.
Right. So what do you want me to do about that?
Nothing. Just let's batch through it.
Do you want me to...
You guys kind of carry me through it.
Do you want me... do you want me to be quieter?
No.
I can be quieter.
You entertain the audience.
I can be very quiet.
Entertain the audience.
I can be very quiet. We could get the ASMR. We could get the ASMR crowd.
No, it makes me cringe.
I've just shaved. I can't do that. Martin could do a fucking beezer. The dog was dead. Scrape. I've got my rubber underpants on.
What the fuck? What was that?
It was a small orgasm.
You know what? It was actually like... It was the rest of that joke, I cut it off and it came out like without syllables. I had to expend the energy and put it in. Fucking Richard Conway.
Dickie Conway.
Like, if we're going to be fucking blast out Martin Langdon's last time, who's he any less of a dog? Dickie Conway, fuck sake.
We should leave all that in, it should be quite funny.
We're just creating these folklore heroes.
Just bleep the guy's name out, but keep Everton in.
Because Mark Lanlon's just getting a free pass last time.
Yeah, it's my turn.
This is Willie's website's down.
Is it actually down?
Yeah.
Have you just failed
it? Ghastly Tales took it down. Ghastly Tales fan bought it out. Right.
Museum.
Martin's went out to the museum because he's one of those cultured fellows. One
of the alleged cultured fellows.
Smokes cigarettes and...
Smokes tar.
Has a ridiculous ponytail that mocks him every turn. I hate you.
Were we doing this joke when we were recording? When did we start recording?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Where am I?
What's my name?
You're about to finish this beer off.
Alright, okay.
There's only a bit left in it.
Splish splash, I'm having a bath. Okay, let's get the energy up. Let's get the... On a roll of six, Martin cracks a smile. I'm looking! Hey, a smoke, please. Right, okay.
Splish, splash, I'm just taking a bath. I've not heard that song since 1965.
Martin's rocking out in the gift shop. I've got a stick of rock for Watson to hit him with. The fucking
joining
film.
You in the museum, Martin. Oh, yeah. We can have a wee talk about culture and about the pieces that you see.
Seems like Martin's choosing to hold on to his...
I forgot you can use it.
Where's the book? Have a book. We'll have a wee conversation while we're in there. We'll look at the paintings and... Look forward to that,
Has anyone seen Exit Through the Gift Shop?
Oh, brilliant. That's the best clue I've ever seen in my life.
I know, but I might actually use this.
Yeah.
I might actually,
Have you seen Exit Through the Gift Shop? It's really interesting documentary.
The Banksy one.
Think it's about Banksy, but it's actually about the guy that followed Banksy around, right? Then Banksy encouraged him to go and do his own art exhibitions. It went to the guy's head and he was making up like bullshit prints of like Elvis with blue hair and selling them for like fucking $65,000. Art's bullshit. And well, says someone with an art degree.
While you're, while Calum's been waxing lyrical about his hatred of it's contemporary art. You don't, art, you don't like.
No.
Art is not bullshit.
A lot of it is.
Some of it is difficult to.
He's going to start talking about Kate Bush.
Conceptual
again.
Art, I think's. When someone puts a brick in the middle of the room and
when your name is Tracy Emmett,
a weary path,
an unmade bed,
and it's made 100
get to fuck you silly
so Martin chocolate. Has blocked the museum, which is sneaky and you, where are you, Calum?
Typical Yates. I'm right here.
Does anyone think they're close to solving any of the 3 points?
Like a rhinestone cowboy. Totally unconnected.
No. McPhail, you're up.
Right. Okay, let me read the card temporarily. I need to find if there's anywhere else worthy of a visit.
Do you know what's really, really silly of me is that I wrote certain stuff on the back of this sheet.
But everyone can see it.
And basically didn't write down where I got those clues from. So that was good. I'm pretty sure that one was the part.
See the locksmith in the Scotland Yard, can they give you clues?
Yep.
Fuck.
Yeah,
okay. Okay.
I've already been there, Kevin.
I sure.
Do we like have a list of people that we can accuse or?
Yeah, in that, there's names of
Professor
people.
Plum.
There's like the on duty police officers are there. But we have to. So it's got to be. Well, I think sometimes with them, it's not the people that are on the cut. Like, you get the names of the person
as you go around.
You go and get the clues.
Okay.
Right, here we go.
It's not the strange lone man outside.
One. I'm sorry, Matt. Put your wee man back in the bowl. Here we go. Guarding it.
So that means Martin's sealed in.
Yes. I know. Forever and ever. Idiot. That was six, but never mind.
Seven. Eight.
I shall open your hive of secrets. But now I shan't. But no, I may, because you both replied that I deduce that you both made an attempt to seem as if it was a errant shitty place.
All right.
However, it may be something good.
Oh, hurry on, decide what you're doing.
I think you two might be performing a ruse. but as I am nearby, it is no consequence.
Bastard. You should have locked that before I got in.
Sure.
Aye, I think so, because I don't know if, like, because the only reason I went...
He's picked up waves from us.
The only reason I went to the museum is because of something else that I read earlier on. Since all of you now know what that clue is, would you like to read out what it says, Calum?
Uriah Wiggins was denied a loan at the Van Zandt's bank.
No, what does it actually say?
If change was found under the cab seat cushions, one of Radcliffe's passengers. No clue. Right, no clue, okay? Much like us.
That's good.
High point.
I just can't fucking trust you, so it had to be done. And the museum should not be locked to the public. fucking public service.
There you go. I just move that. Oh, I check out these moves he's got.
You alright, Ali? Did you ever used to do this?
Drawing something?
Did you ever used to do this at school and you'd be like, oh, do you want to be in the pen club? Right? And they'd be like, the fuck's the pen club? And you'd be like, aye, no problem, right? And I'll show you, right? So you'd write pen, right? And they'd be like, oh, they'd be like, what do you mean? You'd be like, but like pen, right? You'd write pen and you'd be like, right, I need to give you your number of the club, right? Your number is 15.
He's just done it to himself.
Pen 15, and then you'd write, basically write penis in the back of their hand, and then they'd be like, oh! And then they'd get laughed at the fucking school and bullied until they committed suicide.
Calum was a bully.
I was not a bully. Still am. Fatty! So, ponytail boy!
Of time past. What's his name again?
Just there. Mine was current.
We held Martin down. There'll be no ponytails and get
your fucking... You're an absolute Ricky.
Sex!
You're an absolute Conway of an individual.
One. You've Ricky Conway'd that right up. Is that right, Ricky Conway of a situation?
Just to confirm, Ricky Conway was a stage comedian in 1973 that had a very brief career and then died of alcoholism.
And now works in...
That was completely credible.
We need to leave all that in.
No, but I need
to leave all that in.
Oh, yes, I've got to get my card on the right back.
Everywhere you go... Always take the Conway with you. Everywhere you go.
Conway, are you going?
I know.
Dickie.
Right, okay, whose turn was it? It was yours.
So it's my turn. 4! And I am this gentleman here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Michael, would you like to roll? 4. Interesting.
Right.
Martin?
Wolfram. Just Wolfram.
Oh, Martin. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit, I'm starting to get a 1 and give him a 2. Oh, big silly 8s. Oh, 4. That's 3 4s in a row. What are the odds of that? Someone work it out.
Not that low.
So it's 1 and 6 each time.
Yeah, but the odds are reset.
Yeah,
every
but
time
that's how it continues. Yeah. Okay, I will be heading in the direction of the locksmith. 1, 2, 3.
The scrotsmith.
Yeah, the part of me thinks I should go to the lock.
1, 2, 3, Scotland docks. Yard. Give me the book.
Have you noticed that we seem to have like beaten the competitive nature out of each other?
No, it's still there.
I don't know. I think in Ghost of the Galleon there was something to prove. I think, like, back then, like, if you'd just given us knives and pistols, we would have shot. And
there's
you
no way I'm winning this game, though, because my handwriting is so bad. I can't
you can't go back. Michael was once a doctor, but got sued for malpractice. Right, so, it can only be one of these three people that did it.
Right, language, Martin.
Cretins.
What's your language? I know your ponytail used to enjoy a wee
smoothie. Right, okay. Where are we going? I like that.
Me?
I like that fucking sign above the carriage depot.
Where are we going?
From here, you may take a hansom cab to anywhere on the board. It's like, what a fucking mental thing to write above carriage depot.
You know, we should have had my smoke machine going during this one because it'd be like the foggy streets of London.
Should all get pipes. I was smoking a pipe.
You alright?
Home smoking Watson's pipe.
Really? That's not how you smoke a pipe. No, that's not how you smoke a pipe. Mate.
It's kissing his granny.
Wait, I don't know what you're doing.
That's a pipe.
No. Maybe your granddad's pipe.
Well, that's what the kind of pipe that he would have.
His granddad's long narrow stem of a pipe.
Old granddad's corner.
You suck, son. You don't inhale.
Right. Oh, I really miss your granny. Right.
Grandad Conway.
You've got your granny's taste buds.
Yeah.
Grandad Conway.
Just like your gran.
Grandad Conway, Mrs. Granny Conway. Four.
Where's the fair use of his name? Have to edit this to oblivion.
Nice.
Oh! I knew my man is afoot!
Where were you? Yeah.
Fucking there.
You were down there.
Fuck off.
You're
in the crossroads.
Yeah, I thought
it
was a bit. Whatever. Right, okay. 2. Right. Maybe. 3.
Boom! The Bob's head.
I'm going to play this card on top of your clothes.
That really messed me up on like Glenn was good for that. It's like playing the cars. So is zombies actually playing the cars to mess each other.
Except you're probably not meant to be able to do that. But in our version of zombies and gloom,
you can't use cars from one game in the other game.
Well, I beg to differ because I believe that the actual person didn't die of a bobby, but they died of a radical mutation.
You've been carrying that around in your pocket since.
I tried to use it to pay for my shopping earlier.
For the what?
I'll move on. This
bit. I've realised something very important in this case.
Right.
Three.
I should probably read my clues eventually. One. Hang on, wait.
The longest a game in this is supposed to take is an hour and 20 minutes. So we'll
fucking hurry up.
Is it my shot?
Spent most of that dawdling.
Ah, brilliant.
So, can I go in this entrance? Yeah. You've locked that entrance?
Yeah. No, no, you can't.
No, you can just...
Come on.
Have you got a key?
No, but wait, he's locked it there.
This is like the horror hall of fame all over again.
It's not like... Right, boys, seal off the door, but the back door is late.
No, it's a park. It's a whole park.
It's a crime scene.
He can get past that.
No, he can. He can. It seals off an entire location.
Sorry, mate. Have you been to Scotland Yard yet?
But I'll let you take
No, that's not your key.
It's sitting
there.
It was my key.
I thought it was. He hasn't used the key.
There must be something in here if you're fighting so hard to protect it.
Or I've pulled a Yates and done
my classic.
You'll never pull me.
4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. The case has got interesting. 3 additional homes are now on the case.
No, what the fuck just happened?
3 additional homes are now on the case.
No, 3 additional homes have just been arrested because it turns out they're a paedophile ring. That's it. All of them. Oh, for fucks!
That wasn't me that removed that pipe. No, I didn't notice
we now have a pipeless home.
I didn't notice it earlier on that was hanging off. But I wanted to see... this buffoon would rise to it. He's loving it. 1, 2, 3. The newest agents. Excuse me, 1 copy of Esquire, please.
What do we do now? Martin's not here. Where did Martin go? He just decided
Martin's
to
leave. Gone. Martin solved the case, or I'll have him.
No, stop it.
Okay.
The thing is, I feel like I've got most of the clues, but I don't really understand him. Go, Martin, Callum!
Wait, let me add some.
No, you're cheating. Stop
He's going to know his different handwriting. Now you fucking crumpled it. Now he definitely knows.
No.
This is the OJ Simpson trial all over again.
You're cheating.
Right, be the weapon.
What's your t-shirt say?
I'm not going to unzip.
It says... Nice.
Thanks.
That's an awesome t-shirt. Oh, wow!
Yeah. Those strategic holes are great.
Tassels and everything.
Yeah. And here he comes, striding in like Dickie Conway.
No. He had the strut of Ricky Conway.
The strut of Ricky Conway walks like this, apparently.
like a barrel.
Rolling down a hill.
As a shot, because he's going away. 1. Well rolled.
McPhail. Oh,
well rolled.
Well, that's in no. That, well, no, that's part of it. Look.
No, that's the door.
No, because no, look, that's a different tile. All the other ones.
No, that's.
No, look, it is right. Look, no. That's a different tile, though.
No,
that is a different tile.
No, look, 221 Baker Street has a tile in the front of the door as well.
Right, but do any of the other ones have
221 Baker Street?
Other than 221 Baker Street.
Yeah, look. Perspective on this one. This one's got an awning.
See the door. You have to go into the door, Callum. That's the door there. What's that? That's the bit outside the door. It's the bit, Callum, it's the bit outside the door. That, stop it.
Don't be a
toilet. Look, there's the door there. How are you getting into the newsagents if the door's there?
I'm asking you, look, have you got a clue? No,
I got a clue. I'm getting three other Sherlock Holmes chasing me.
You guys running around I love that he's put himself halfway between that tail.
Oh, he's about to solve it.
Hortle.
Good.
No one cares for this one. It's just kind of like,
I hope someone solves this.
We played this one.
I'm only a rogue one, so am I officially in now?
Yeah, you're in now.
Fuck's sake.
No, you're at the door. You're at the door.
Aye, the fucking subscription.
But you're not in.
See my subscriptions.
You're not in, you're at the door.
Hurry up, I want to see if they've got any magazines about the three recent orders.
The G-Stooges. Right.
Look, he's writing a really fucking tiny writing.
Uh-oh.
It must have been a midget.
It's really hexadecimal format.
Right. Geese the Khan.
He just did, Martin.
Geese Yon Khan. Newsies.
Can't believe
you just touched my foot. Oh! No!
Oh, fuck. Alright, okay.
Pawnbrokers. Where's the card?
Are these kind of like cryptic clues, like you're getting a crossword?
Some of them are,
but... Because I'm really not good at that.
Well, some of them you've got to fill in the blanks. So actually, some of them you need to know a bit about things external to the game in order to do it, which I kind of think is a little bit bullshit. Not that people should all have to be intelligent enough to get it, but... Michael? Do you want to just roll in order to move the game?
No.
While you're writing in. Cool, let's just...
I'm
going to
go to the toilet and I think
I'll
find that I'm taking this with me.
Oh, he's drawn a picture of tits on.
Drawn a picture of Ricky Conway's bot.
Yeah.
Ricky Conway's bot.
Did she fit on that paper?
Well, we take it to the toilet.
Right.
Is it my turn?
Fuck it, aye. For argument's sake, let's say aye.
For fuck. Oh, I've never rolled so many ones.
Wait, you were there, you weren't in the pawnbrokers, were you?
Oh, was that?
Yeah, we can only leave via the exit.
Wait, was that the exit? Oh, no, well, wait a minute, shit.
Well, where did you exit before?
I wanted to get the clue for in that.
Were you there? And you went fucking in the back?
Right, I tell you what we'll do is I'll have to go round and go in. So I need to use
What's
that.
What's this new shite that we're talking?
Michael's fucking...
For some reason, I thought one of these...
Michael
was
plugged in via the fucking window.
I don't know. Sorry. Right, make fail.
This was when you remember when
has he gone in and climbed out the window?
I will go around.
Is there a fire?
No, but remember when zombies fucking finished in 40
Listen,
minutes?
I was going to go to the newsagents next. I will take my turn round. Get a five
as well. Jeez, where am I? Where am I going? Get myself some more pharmaceuticals.
He's rolled a one for you, Cal. He's getting so. I've got to do this. I haven't. See, to be honest, I'm not gonna lie. I have not been trying to put together the clues. Have you? I've not really been doing it.
I've kind of a wee bit, but Callum's writing things that aren't true. Like newsagent, no clue. The stuff is going to the newsagent, but then it could be a double bluff.
Don't fucking read my card.
He's doing it in huge letters.
Do you not think I would want to do huge letters so that I wouldn't bloody go in it myself?
I don't know, but Martin just took about six steps.
I'm here.
Key, please. Right, fucking geezer boot. Geezer the called.
You may wonder why Callum has penis written on his hand.
That's because he's part of the pen club.
He's member number 15.
The 15th member of the pen club. You'll know when you're older.
So where do you think, this ranks third in all the games we've played so far?
First one was Galleon.
Galleon was a fucking piece of a game.
Yeah.
Zombies was alright.
Zombies we made fun.
Yeah.
Gloomer so actually Gloom enjoyed okay. as a game. This is four.
So this would be four. What was below this?
Would you put Zombies before Gloom then?
I can't remember.
Like, which one do you think was better and more enjoyable as a game?
I like Cthulhu Gloom, that was pretty good.
We did sort of abandon the whole storytelling aspect. There shouldn't be this many places with no clue. I know for a fact that news agents does not have no clue in it. We know that for a fact.
I don't know if you're deliberately doing a double negative.
I know for a fact.
News agents doesn't have no clue.
Yeah.
Oh, could go either way.
Michael knows because he climbed via the window rather than the door.
Michael just looked in the window. He didn't even go in, didn't even use a move.
Yeah.
What was with the groan?
Hey, it was the card. Card!
Michael's just realised his own mortality.
Oh my god!
Give me the number for the chemist while you're at it. What's the number for the chemist? I'll give you it if you tell me the number for the chemist.
815.
Is that made up?
No.
Where's my pen? I'll just write this. It's pretty funny when Mike was raging and he really wanted the clue. He was like, he was like Ricky Conway when we pushed him on his back and he couldn't get up. Holding a donut just out of reach.
God, do you know what? Actually, you know, I used to like board games.
The thing is, this is what's the age on this again? It's like 10 and up, right?
Yeah.
And I've got some of the complete clues, and I don't have a skimmy.
Yeah, but the thing is, right? There's some historical ones, right? And the only way to answer them is to know the answers.
Aye.
Is to know the answer to these historical questions.
You're not a very good detective. You don't have your general knowledge, Cam.
Yeah, but does a fucking 8-year-old know much about fucking Henry VIII?
No, but obviously a 26-year-old doesn't either.
Aye, but fucking, well, no, I did, I got the answers, but...
You may notice, guys, that I've taken up smoking. Like, I don't know if you can see this.
For example, Sir Henry Blank is a famous sculptor.
Why did you replace Blank with Cunt?
And I won't get the answer.
Has everyone pretty much resigned themselves individually to not winning? So we're just waiting for someone else to put it together. Nobody's going to do it.
So we can be released from this misery.
I know. It's the thing as well. I'm trying to figure out shit, so everyone be quiet.
Why can't you even just roll to just get it going? Right.
That's not my roll unless it's six.
One.
I don't know how that happened, it was mum.
It went way over there.
You got really long legs under the telly. You know how tall he is? Can I have the dice, please?
Don't let me stroke your foot again, mate.
Chatty, read my clothes. Why are you getting the PVC tape out, Carl?
Keep reading your book.
Why are you getting the PVC tape out, Carl?
Reading your book?
No. Actually, did you get that at the pound shop? Because I actually need to get some.
Yeah, Tommy Walsh.
Is it the pound shop? I'll need to get some tomorrow. Right, nice. Right. Four.
This is
going to pop. Right, yes. He's reading my answers.
Oh yeah, fuck, I need the answer out of that.
It was number four. You can actually look there. But it would have been hilarious if I'd just given you a clue from a completely other different case.
Oh,
You look great. That looks really good. Is that on your eyebrows? There you go, you're fine. You shouldn't play with fire, Callum. This is what happens.
I'm imagining that.
Don't ruin the giraffe face.
It's Michael's party. Right, on a roll of six, it's done.
Fucking hell.
Right, is it my turn now?
I'm looking at this now, and it's got to the point where I'm just going to random places.
Yeah, I don't even know. I'm just visiting places, ticking them off the list.
I've got pretty much all the locations.
Okay.
What are you doing? You alright?
Writing down a clue, yeah.
Yeah, you meant to lick your pen, though.
Like, some of these, though, like, feel like, they should be big clues, right? But then you're like, who the fuck is this a reference to?
Okay.
The game seems to have expanded into new horizons.
Well, I've answered one of the clues.
Right, okay.
But that's it.
Nobody cares.
We just hope you're right.
That's it. I've answered one of the clues, that's it.
How are you meant to write all this fucking down?
I've got all but four clues.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
You're still fucked.
I've solved one.
Mm-hmm.
It is three.
Why don't we collaborate to come up with the answer?
Yeah, I've got one as well. Yeah, I've fucking got it.
Right.
What have you got? Which part of the clues do you think?
I've got the murder.
What about you?
I've got the wedding.
Shut up out there, I can hear you. We are playing a game of deductive reasoning.
I know, you're outside on a Saturday night.
There's been bloody murders.
I've got the weapon, you've got the killer. What have you got?
I think I could probably take a stab at motive.
Right. I think I could maybe do the motive.
Right, so should we all share it?
Okay.
Right.
No, but are we genuinely...
We're playing to the bitter end. I'm done with this.
I want to go and drink.
You're done with this?
I'm done.
I'm conferring this game to you.
I'll give you the weapon used. The weapon used, I think, is a shovel.
Right? Yeah, I think it is as well, but that was part...
It's two parts.
One. Now, so what's part two?
EL.
Part two was the letter L.
All right. Okay.
Yep. So L, we had L.
You wouldn't need the second part.
Wait, no, I was like, that looks like shovel. It can't be shovel because it's the second
what's,
part.
So part two, is that the weapon? What L, done, so yeah, did, so did you had L and then I had EL. So shovel does go together.
So,
For the killer, it's Colonel Sebastian Moran, right, who matched the description. But I also got a bit
is
of
he somebody in this.
I also got a bit of information as well, which was that he killed them in order to, he used them to commit another murder and then killed them to cover it up.
I think
so that's the motive.
Wait a minute, wait a minute.
The bank, it said the biggest gold deposit ever.
No, they're digging a tunnel into the bank.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I think they dug the tunnel and he killed them off to
cover it up.
Because yeah. There's a clue for motive, that's one is sounds like ton.
Yeah.
Ton.
Yeah.
And the second half is something that was, what was it, like shell without
had a dank smell not unlike that found in a cellar, which a tunnel would be.
Yeah, and also when you go into the Scotland Yard, there's vacant premises with a cellar and a boiler. Yeah.
Also, so Colonel Sebastian
Scotland Yard is right next to
Colonel
the
Sebastian digging Moran is Yard, also a known associate of Professor Moriarty.
There was the book over. We shall see if... Right, so let's put this...
Right, who's Lestrade? Who's Lestrade?
So who did you say was the killer?
It's Colonel Sebastian Moran.
Okay, and you said the motive was...
He was killing off the people who were involved in digging the tunnel.
To rob the bank.
Right, so you said it was the largest ever deposit of gold was
and you said it was a shovel.
And they used the
Before we open it, which character are you? You can either be Watson, Sherlock or Lestrade.
I'll be Watson.
You're Watson?
Sherlock.
Right, I'm Lestrade. We've worked together to solve this case, as the police would do.
Yes.
Let us see then if we've cracked this case. Solution to the adventure of the bludgeoning Bobby. Colonel Sebastian Moran An associate of the notorious Professor Moriarty disguised himself as a policeman. Maybe didn't get that.
Well, that made sense.
And led his victims to believe they were being taken to Scotland Yard for questioning in some top secret police matter.
Which we didn't say.
Once at Scotland Yard, Moran led the victims to the cellar of the vacant premises behind Scotland Yard, where he provided them with a shovel and forced them at gunpoint to work all night digging a tunnel to the bank. Dawn, Moran used the shovel to bludgeon his victims to death, and he then transported their bodies to the park. At the rate of one man per night, Moran had hoped to finish his tunnel in time to reach the bank vault when the special gold shipment arrived later in the month. So technically we didn't get the full story, but technically we did get the killer. We got the weapon, which was shovel, and we got the motive, which was the tunnel to the
bank. And also at the pawnbroker we got, he had them do the dirty work, which was a reference to them doing it. The soil between Scotland Yard and the bank was pitch black earth. Right. But that's what tells you that bit there, because it says the soil between Scotland Yard and the bank.
We didn't get the full story.
That doesn't matter. Someone's been brought to justice.
We got the three, but...
So if you're a murderer out there, beware, because between the three of us, you're fucked.
Will we do a talking heads bit now?
No, because nobody won.
No, but we normally still do a talking heads bit where we talk about what we think of the game.
What are you going to say, though?
No.
Well, this is the second case that we've played for the Sherlock Holmes game. I think we found it quite boring this time around.
Despite the captivating
and
title.
And there's 75 cases, and some of those cases are multi-parts, so you're meant to actually play like more than one case to get the overarching story.
Wait a minute. Adventure of the Bludgeoning Bobby, part one.
No, that...
Sorry, guys.
But if that case is anything to go by, we probably wouldn't want to play the other parts. But I still think
Did you say your wife bought you this?
Yes, and it was a lovely gift.
It was absolutely fantastic.
We enjoyed it more the first time. We definitely did enjoy it.
I think it's probably dependent.
It was a novelty, I think.
No, but I think it's probably dependent on the case that you get as well. I don't know, and the energy levels from Martin Yates.
Yep. Hopefully next time we're going to be doing Laser Quest.
Yeah.
I voted for that.
Next time up, we've got another retro game going back to the same sort of thing we did when we did Ghostly Galleons. So do come back to Ghastly Tales, and we will be here for another Bloody Board Games. Say goodbye, Callum.
Games.
Hurrah!
Bye-bye, Callum.
So should we have some kind of, wait, we'll put our hands
bye up, Martin, because you're never going to play again.
Before we all solve this, everyone put your hands in the middle, right? 3, 2, 1. Bloody Board Games! Hey!
Don't buy this.
Yeah, you can get drunk.
Alright, cool. Fucking hell.
In the unlikely event that anyone's still around to hear me say this, we hope you enjoyed Bloody Board Games. And if you're not already, please feel free to subscribe to the channel in order to see more of our nonsense gaming, or, on the other hand, our short films or narrations. If there's anything you particularly liked, feel free to leave a comment below. If there was anything you particularly didn't like, feel free to leave a comment below. But we may feel free to censor and delete it in some kind of tyrannical dictatorship type way. Only joking, we don't actually delete any comments, we just read them, soak up all the negative energy, kill ourselves slowly inside, crying for quite a while, take it out in each other, then we come back kind of fresh-faced in order to do it all again. So yeah, ideally leave a good comment. If you don't, we've gradually built up a shield over time. So yep, hopefully you've enjoyed Bloody Board Games, and we will see you in the next one. Goodbye!